Hello. Today we are going to evaluate BioFLX, a new prefabricated resin crown by NuSmile. According to the manufacturer, it's an existing high-impact biocompatible hybrid resin polymer. This material comes from the medical field and has a proven track record with strength, flexibility, and durability. One interesting aspect to this material versus previous competitors like the Figaro crown, which is a fiberglass resin polymer, is the improved ductility and plasticity of the material, allowing it to withstand occlusal forces longer. Another improvement is the purported color stability, which is an advantage of the previous Figaro crown and the D2932 prefabricated resin crown field that'll allow this material to have a long-term aesthetic solution with a preparation time and learning curve similar to a stainless steel crown with minor adjustments. This review is going to assess a BioFLX crown on T as in Thomas and S as in Sierra, reviewing the directions for use to seat these crowns successfully. When first started placing the BioFLX crowns, I initially first prepared a standard stainless steel crown preparation and fit stainless steel crown sizes, as seen in the following video. Please feel free to watch my previous vital pulp therapy videos, but the pulp should be non-bleeding after the removal of cotton pellets. The pulp therapy is then applied, which is Neoputty by NuSmile, and then GC Equia Forte is placed as an obtundant and is condensed into the chamber. Interproximal reduction is then completed similar to a stainless steel crown preparation. Primary second molar, lower right 5, and a primary first molar, lower right 5 stainless steel crowns are selected as appropriate sizes for the crown preparations. The crowns are then removed and the corresponding BioFLX crown sizes are selected. When adapting a stainless steel crown preparation for a BioFLX crown preparation, additional occlusal reduction, circumferential reduction is noted. As you can see in the video, there is spring back and bouncing of the corresponding BioFLX crown sizes, not allowing for the snug active fit. So further occlusal reduction and minor circumferential preparation is required. With the additional occlusal reduction, there is a functional bevel that is rounded and placed on the buccal and lingual cusp. All sharp point and line angles and preparation sharp points are rounded and smoothed. This is different from your standard stainless steel crown prep. Additional interproximal reduction includes circumferential reduction with minor reduction of the buccal bulge and lingual walls. Proximal line angles are also rounded and smooth. This will allow for the snug and active fit that the BioFLX crown requires. This preparation is significantly less aggressive than a prefabricated zirconia preparation, but also slightly more than a pediatric's preformed stainless steel crown. This is the final preparation of the BioFLX crowns that allowed for the size 5 BioFLX crowns that were similar to the stainless steel crown try-ons. While learning this prep, I've been just prepping a stainless steel crown preparation and seeing what I have to do to alter that preparation to allow for the snug and active fit of the BioFLX crowns. Trying on the same crown sizes again, you can appreciate that the bounce has been removed and the crowns now have an active snug fit. A band seater can be used when seating the crowns. This may cause the self-adaptive nature of the material. The crown should have a snug and active glove-like fit that requires an instrument like a cleoid discoid to remove. Prior to cementation, the preparations and crown should be cleaned similarly to that of a stainless steel crown. A glass ionomer cement like Fuji One or Keytac can be utilized, or a resin-modified glass ionomer cement like Reliance or Fujisem 2 can also be utilized to cement these crowns. The BioFLX crowns in this clinical example are being cemented with Keytac Maxi Cap. The crowns are filled and placed. A crown seater is then used to fully seat both crowns. Excess is then removed and rinsed. In conclusion, what do I think of BioFLX? I think it is a nice improvement over the pre-existing prefabricated resin crowns that is a compromise between stainless steel crowns and prefabricated pediatric zirconia crowns. I think the preparations are tooth conservative. That offers a full coverage, high aesthetic option with a lower learning curve and lower time to preparation than preformed pediatric zirconia crowns. I think this newer material is very durable and has increased plasticity and ductility than its predecessors. I'm interested to see how this is going to affect the current market of prefabricated aesthetic pediatric crowns.